Hey YouTube, Savon Draws here. Today we have more updates for Toonsquid 2.0 that dropped last week. We're going to get into them really quickly, but first I'd like to say I started a new Discord where my subscribers can join and you can just send in your animations or your art to get featured on the channel, on the videos. So just make sure to join my channel. The link will be in the description. Just go to the send in channel and send in your work. Basically, this Discord will just be a place where you can share your animations, speak with the community, and learn more about mobile creative software for art and animation, even 3D. So make sure to stop on by. Now let's get to the video. Now, first of all, we have a lot of updates for Toonsquid, and I'll be leaving chapters on this video so you can skip to any specific chapter that interests you for the new features. First off, the most interesting feature to me is that we now have support for keyboard shortcuts. So we can see that if we just go to actions and go to our settings, we can go to keyboard, and now we can set all of our actions with keyboard shortcuts. So everything that I have set in blue are basically shortcuts that I've already changed on my keyboard, and everything with the basic gray color is the basic command for the shortcut. So what I could do is I could just click on any command and I can click a different button and it will change the command. So you can also click X to get rid of the command you change it to. So it's very, very easy. So I've set the brush tool to D, but if I wanted, I could set it back to B. And then we'll go back, and if I click B, of course, it selects my brush tool. So really nice quality of life feature for any of you who use keyboards or like a macro pad or shortcut keyboard. Going forward, now we finally have some updates for the Apple Pencil Pro. If you don't have an Apple Pencil Pro with the new line of iPads, you can feel free to skip this chapter of the video and go to the next part. But basically, if we go to settings and then we go to tools and we go to brush, we can click to enable a cursor. We can click cursor hover preview. Just make sure that's on. And then as you can see, I'm not touching the screen right now and my cursor is being tracked. When I actually do touch the screen, of course, it will draw. Additionally, another update we have for the Apple Pencil Pro is that we can now basically use barrel roll on our brushes. So if I were to change to another brush, I could go into this brush settings by going to edit, and then I can go to rotation, and I could change the brush's rotation with barrel roll. So of course I'd have to change my rotation behavior as well as my barrel roll control. And now we can see as I rotate my pencil, my cursor is rotating as well. I'll just make it bigger so you can see. Now we can also do this for the size and the opacity of our brush. So we can go to barrel roll control for size. And as I roll my pencil, it becomes significantly bigger. Or I could put it lower and it will change how it works. And this feels much more natural. Finally, we can also control the opacity with barrel roll by, once again, just putting up the barrel roll control. And we'll see the marks I already made will reflect how the barrel roll control is reading the strokes I already made. And if I were to make a new stroke, I'd probably put this lower. And then this feels pretty natural. I could put it around here. And as I tilt my pencil, it just changes the opacity. Something else we can do is now we can set a application-wide pressure curve. So we can go to settings, and then we'll go to tools, and then we'll go down to pressure curve. And if we click on this, we'll just be able to edit our pressure curve for our whole application. This will affect every brush. And you can also reset it however you want. Additionally, we also have system-wide smoothing now. So we can put our minimum smoothing that we want for every single brush. And then if we want to make it work on all of our brushes, ignoring our smoothing options that are already set on the brush, we'll just click override smoothing settings. And if I put it super high, my brush would be super smooth, but also super slow. Additionally, we have two more smoothing options that can be applied at a app-wide level or just in your brush settings specifically. So I'm not quite sure how these smoothing options work myself, but what I will do is I'll display a description of them from the Toonsquid website. So we have show gap, catch up when stroke ends, and adjust with speed. But I will say the adjust with speed option is pretty interesting, as basically it will speed up and slow down how it smooths your brush based on how fast you draw. Something new we can do is we can also go to our settings and we can flip through drawings instead of just frames. So to display this, we'd go to settings, we would go to gestures, and we would go to page flip. Now, our regular page flip behavior when we scroll up and down with three fingers would be to scroll through frames like this, one by one. But what we can change instead is we can go to settings and we can click on flip through drawings instead of frames. And if we do this, it would just go straight to my next drawing. As you can see, these are all double frames and it skips the second frame and goes to the next drawing. We can also now go to settings and on our gestures, we can take off select layers on the canvas. And when we do this, when we're on our transform tool, we won't select different layers when we're clicking around on our screen. If we take it off, we can select different layers just by clicking when we're on the transform tool. And you see, it will just keep switching my layers based on where I'm clicking. Another quality of life update is that if we're using the eraser tool or the smudge tool first, and then we go to the eyedropper tool, once we select our color, it will automatically go back to brush without me having to click on the brush tool. So yeah, that's it. It's a small update, but it brought quite a few useful features, and I think there are a lot of cool things on the way. I'm very happy with Toonsquid 2 so far. Once again, everyone join the Discord if you can, and I hope you have a good time. I hope you learned something good in this video. Subscribe if you did. Have a good one. Bye.